Welcome back to another episode of Soul Aligned Success. And today I'm going to share with you why you should stop all free coaching immediately. This is such an important message for coaches and healers that are continuously coaching for free and attempting to build a business at the same time. There's nothing wrong with giving out free content. My entire business model is based around giving 90% of the content out for free. I only charge for about 10% of the content that I put out. 90% of everything else that I create, masterclasses, podcasts, videos, live streams, you name it, I offer it for free, including strategy sessions, which are of massive value. Whether or not somebody signs up with me or not, I'm always delivering massive value and leading with generosity. So that being said, if you're trying to build a business though, and you keep coaching people for free, then what you're going to attract are people that only want free information and or not willing or able to invest in themselves at this time. And that's what the free content is for. It's for people that aren't able to invest in themselves at this time. That's why you continuously give out free content, right? But you can't also treat your coaching services this way. You can't offer, keep coaching for free and then wonder why people don't want to pay you, or all of a sudden you start talking about a package that's for sale and it just is crickets. Why is that? Because you've been putting out the vibration that your services, your coaching services, are not worthy of compensation and are not of high value. And you continuously give out free coaching. Free coaching does not equal a profitable business model. So if you are attempting to build a business as an entrepreneur, then you have to have paid services that are paid, and you can still give out free services that are free, right? But you have to be able to draw the line, and you have to be able to discern the difference between giving out free content that is useful and beneficial and inspiring and transformative, but also what is going to be reserved for paid clients that are willing and able to invest in themselves at this time, right? Because there are people right now willing and able to invest in the exact program and offer that you have, but yet they are unable to find you because energetically you keep prostituting your services and putting them out there really, really cheaply or inexpensively or for free. And so there is no perceived value there. And the people that you keep attracting are the people that are not willing or able to invest in themselves. And so if this is happening to you and this is a pattern, this is a cycle, what's happening is the people that are showing up are a reflective mirror for you to consider that you need to take your services more seriously, and you need to put together a business model that generates revenue for your company so that you can continue to sustain your mission and your work. And recognize that the clients that are showing up to you that are unable to pay or unwilling to pay or are fine taking, right? But they're not fine investing in their own growth process. That's the reason they're not willing to invest and value their own growth process is because, and they're showing up in front of you, is because you are not valuing your own services. And so this is an example of how your clients are an excellent mirror for you. I've done a whole nother video on why clients are your mirror, or potential clients are your mirror, because there is a message there for you that it's time to treat your business like a business and hold your services as sacred. There's a sacred exchange that takes place when someone comes to you with a problem that you are able to help them heal and or transmute, and they invest in themselves to get that result. Then they actually do get the result. But when people are not willing and able to invest time, energy, or money into what it is that they want, they don't get the result, right? They're the ones that, you know, drop off early. They're the ones that don't do the work. They're the ones that try to deflect all responsibility to you for the results as the coach versus them taking accountability for integrating the work. right? And you'll see these themes popping up if you continue to offer your services from that energetic standpoint that they are not worthy of compensation and they're not worthy of value. And this is always the underlying belief system, whether it's conscious or unconscious, that hides underneath this pattern. And that is the belief that I can't be successful in what I love to do. I can't make money doing what I love. I can't make money doing my passion work. Some people even have a belief that it's wrong to monetize your gift and offer it to people who want to invest to begin with. There's lots of dogmas out there that are could be affecting you on a very unconscious level. And there's also the belief that you may not be worthy of the business that you dream about and all of that. So, and then the actions that you take are giving out your services for free coaching and this and that. Like, you take the actions that then yield the results of no one being able to pay you, but you are the cause. You are the cause in that because you have full control on how you present your services and how you position yourself. This is all about healthy boundaries. And I want to point out that if this is happening in your business, then I guarantee you can recognize other areas of your life where this has happened as well. So where else do you have poor healthy boundaries? Where else do you self-sacrifice? Where else do you overgive? Where else do you put your time, energy, effort, or love, or whatever into something that is not being reciprocated and not being returned to you, right? And that there's not a mutual exchange happening, right? And so I want you to ask those questions because there's a parallel there and it's happening probably in more areas of your life than just your business. And this is why I say that your spiritual business is your number one ascension tool, because as you up level your inner reality and value yourself and value your services and value your gift, you will begin to draw healthier boundaries and set healthier standards. And then you will call in the clients that are willing to invest in themselves through your program and empower themselves through your program, because you've now made yourself energetically available for them to find you. So I hope this finds you well. If you liked this video and you have a question or comment, please leave it below the video wherever you happen to be watching this. And if this really interests you, then this is exactly what I teach my clients inside Sacred Leader Academy. It's a piece of what I teach, actually. I teach a lot more than this, but if you want a taste of what that is, then sign up for the masterclass below this video. And I look forward to seeing you very, very soon in an upcoming episode. Namaste.